What is up, everyone, and welcome to the 6th Collaborator Instagram Live Musician Spotlight. For those of you that don't know me, my name is Seth Kitchen, and I run daily operations here in Springfield, Missouri. We run a GPS-based music application where we work hard to get our users more exposure, more revenue, and collaborators for their music. What's up, Wavy Prod? I see you there, and two others joining. Glad to have you here for the first time. One of the ways that we can get you guys more exposure is to get your stories out there through this wonderful musician spotlight. Another thing is we'll post your album covers and news whenever they come out, so go ahead and DM us, and then we'll try and get it on our Instagram page. And if you're interested in telling your story, shoot us a DM on Instagram, and we'll work on scheduling you in for an interview as well. Today we have a solo artist, Angie Florio, aka Bunny, from New York. Her sound is a little kind of like Billie Eilish. It's kind of a stretch, but some of her recent tracks have been kind of more rap and R&B. One of the reasons we picked her out is we think her vocals would be great on some of the instrumentals we have on our platform. But with that, let's try and get her on the call. Welcome, guys. Welcome. We got a huge crowd right now. It's awesome. Let's see. Get her on the call here. Hey, what's going on?
Hey, what's up?
Glad to have you.
Thank you.
Thank you so much for coming on.
Thank you for inviting me.
Yeah, definitely. So let's start off the bat with your name. Bunny, how'd you come up with that?
Okay, Bunny. So I have 4 pet rabbits, and my love of bunnies just kind of sprouted for like the past 2 years. And it just sort of became my thing. Like everyone just sort of, like every time someone would see a bunny, it'd be sent to me. I just became the bunny girl, so I just started kind of going by Bunny, and like my music, I was like, I should like turn this into like my brand, like I should really do something with this. So I just started with the bunny thing.
Yeah, for sure. So do you have a pet or no?
Yeah, I have 4 rabbits.
Oh my god, that's crazy.
What are the names? Winnie was my first one. Pip Pip, Piper, and Cinnabon are my 4 rabbits.
Awesome. So you wouldn't expect that in New York, right? Like pet rabbits, is that a big thing in the big city or no?
I mean, sometimes it depends, because it's hard, because rabbits have really, like, they're not hard of hearing. Their hearing is very sensitive, so their vibrations and everything they hear it's so much larger than ours, so they get startled so easily that I feel like it's not as common around there just because of the noise levels. But right. that's just my knowledge of it.
So tell us more about the music industry in New York. Like, how is it over there? Do you think it's easy to get your music out there? Is it a lot of studios that you can work at? And just things like that.
I mean, it depends where you are, really. Because that's where I'm from. I currently live in RVA, in that sort of area. So I work with artists around my area, because I've been blessed to have a lot of really creative people in my circle and really help me out and get me to the point where I'm at right now, which is a lot. I credit a lot of that to Radar Lavar. He's a big artist around here, and he helped me out a lot. Just a little. I have to give credit where it's due. But I have a lot of people who've pushed me in this industry, and he's definitely one of them. So, I mean, I can really credit him for a lot of it. And I usually go into his...
Oh yeah. So did you learn everything from him? Is that what you say, or how did you even stumble upon music, where you're like, I want to do this as a hobby or as a career? Or... Right. So we're getting some comments that you might be cutting out. So let me try and re-invite you here. So I re-invite her. Let's see if that clears up the connection. Sorry about that, guys. Welcome back.
Okay.
I think it's a little bit better. It's clearer this time, so I think it should be good.
Okay.
So let's talk about how you classify your music. So I mentioned Billie Eilish initially, but I think that's kind of a stretch. Like, I was trying to think of who would you classify? What kind of box can we put you in around your genre?
Mm-hmm. I don't know, because I mean, I can't really pinpoint, like, an exact artist. I like to say alternative, because it's been hard for me to, like, try to find a genre to put my music in. It has, because I don't know exactly what I am. I just kind of make, like, whatever beat I like, I just kind of stick with it, and then I just write to it, and it can go from anywhere to, like, a ballad to, like, a rap song. Like, it's within a very wide range of things, so I just like to say alternative, just kind of, like, put it, like, just right there.
Oh, yeah, for sure. So what about, like, the people who influence your music? So do you, like, you know, listen to people on the radio and say, hey, that's really cool, I want to kind of incorporate that into my music a little bit? Or who do you, like, aspire to be? Who do you want to work with? That sort of thing.
Every now and then, like, I'll just hear a song and I'll hear something that I like one little, like, ooh, I really like that, and try to incorporate something like that in my next song. Or, like, if I like that style or something with, like, what they did with the lyrics, how the melody's going, I try to do that myself just to see how it would sound on me. A lot of my friends that I have who make music, they influence me a lot because they have a lot of great music, and I like to sound, like, good in my music, and then I collaborate with them, and it turns into their style and my style. So,
right,
yeah.
So what comes first, the lyrics in a song, or do you write the music first, or do you write them, like, at the same time?
Well, usually I search for a beat to find, because I don't produce my own beats. I usually purchase a beat, or have one of my friends produce a song for me. That's usually how that goes. So I find a beat that I like, and if I like it a lot, then I'll start, like, just writing to it, and I'll just keep going until the whole song's done, and just rehearse it and see how the whole thing sounds, and then I'll go to the studio and put it down and get it engineered, and then it'll eventually be out. That's usually how that works.
Yeah, so Send the Demon's asking, what type of context do you use for your lyrics?
It all just comes right here.
Oh,
I go on my notes app, and I just straight up just start going.
So it's like life experiences. Is that what you're saying?
Yeah, basically every single thing that my songs are in has been a crazy life experience within the last couple of years of my life that I've been able to project using that, because it's my biggest source right now to actually get it out.
Right. So what's your music setup look like? What kind of, like, so you say you don't produce, right? But you have to mix with the beats that you buy or whatever.
Yeah.
So how do you do that? Do you record at your home, a studio, or you work at someone else's place?
I work at my friend Rated R Lavar's studio. He's been gracious enough to let me go and record whenever I need to in his studio, and he'll engineer it for me and help me and everything like that. So I always hop over to his studio, and he's always helping me out, like, right there with it. So I big ups to him.
Yeah. So you record the vocals and stuff at his place too?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Okay, awesome. All the recording is done over there, and then I'll mix it with him, and he'll do most of the work because he's more tech savvy with GarageBand and stuff than I am. So he'll do all that, and then he'll send it to me, and we'll get it going.
Right. Do you have any GarageBand fans out there in the chat? Because we have a lot of FL Studio, I think, from last kind of stuff. But
FL, yeah, that's it.
Yeah.
Yeah, those two are the big ones, yeah.
Yeah, for sure. So my favorite song of yours is Pretty Boys. I think you did it quite a while ago. But I think it kind of reflects, like, all of your different unique sounds. Can you kind of walk us through your ideas for that song and the process of creating it, maybe?
Fun fact, I actually recently performed that at a showcase at my school. So that was actually a recently performed song. So
where do you go?
But I go to Thomas Dale here in Virginia. We've gotten, like, a bit of notoriety because we had Shayla Wynn on American Idol, and she was, like,
wow,
the huge thing, and she attended our school, and we have Trey Songz and his family attends it, so, like, it's like a, I don't know, we're kind of known for, like, having famous alumni, but I just try to do what I do.
Yeah, for sure.
Just trying to get through it. But Pretty Boys, that was like that was kind of like a dump of, like, this is my melting pot, and I just dump it out in that song just to, because I've realized I had quite the pattern. That basically just sums it up right there.
Okay. So how do you find collaborators for you? So I see a lot of like different producers and people that you work with, like rappers as well, on your tracks. So like, how do you find these people?
Usually I have like friends of friends and then their friends, or I'll be online and I'll like go on like a website where you can purchase beats or something. And then like, I'm always going to give credit to whoever produces.
What kind of site do you buy your beats off of?
Usually just BeatStars, because it's like the most professional, and I think a lot of good producers are like really on there. If it's not one of my friends, then that's probably where I'm at to get beats.
Right. So do you like competition stuff on like Splice maybe, or other places like that? Or is that, have you never seen those before?
No.
Okay. Gotcha. So the reason that we're interested in you as well is because we have a bunch of like great pop and EDM and R&B beats on our system. Like for instance, Paul Saint, we interviewed him a couple weeks ago. He has like these amazing tracks he just came out with, but they don't have any vocals, and he's found some vocalists for them, but it just doesn't do him justice. So I was wondering, are you interested in working on any of those? Can we send those to you later?
Okay, yeah, you awesome. Can definitely send those.
So someone asked this earlier as well, is what do you see for yourself in the future? What kind of your biggest struggles and the goals for your music are?
In the future, I hope to be doing something with my music, whether it's singing or songwriting. Or modeling, at the very least. It's like something that I want to be within that realm. I have a lot of struggles with it because it's hard to gain a lot of notoriety when you're this small, because no one really wants to pay attention to you. And in the area I am specifically, it's very male dominated. We have a lot of great artists, but maybe 10% of them are women, me included. So it's really hard to get people around here to pay attention to like women, because it's so male oriented. Like, I'm a boy and I'm rapping and I'm in the RVA and it's so hard, but I have quite a few people that still support me and are with me, so I appreciate them to the fullest, but that's probably my biggest struggle with it.
Oh yeah. So what would you say along those lines about someone getting started? Like if you're a female in this society that, you know, is male dominated, how do you, you know, break through? How do you find your confidence and kind of get out there?
You really just got to like push through it no matter what, because I have a lot of doubts, and you're gonna have a lot of doubts, especially if you're a woman saying like, oh, I don't belong here, there's so many boys here, like there's no way I'm gonna make it there, like this is not for girls, especially with the rapping, because I don't exclusively rap, but I can definitely do it, so it's really difficult to like try to squeeze in spots where you feel like you're not welcomed or you don't belong. So you just really gotta ignore all the male persistence and try to make a way for the women. That way there is a way for women, and put yourself into the woman realm.
Yeah. No, I get that. That's great.
Yeah.
So is there anything else you'd like to say? That's kind of the end of my question spiel before we head out of here.
Just keep doing it. Bunnies are great.
Oh,
and
yeah.
Thank you so much for having me here.
Yeah, I appreciate it.
Thank you for everybody who's watching.
Appreciate it. Talk to you later.
Thank you so much.
So that's kind of the end of this Instagram spotlight. So like I said, if you guys are interested in being on this and having your story be told, go ahead and shoot us a DM and we'll get back to you as quick as possible. We have a lot in our inbox right now. We're sorting through them, so it's going to be kind of hard to get through them all, but we'll get there as soon as possible and we'll reach out as fast as possible. So thank you guys so much for tuning in. Thanks for watching and supporting us. We appreciate it. We'll talk to you later.